University of Houston.
The quads, knights, kings, and medieval times. What do these things have in common? Well, the SCA, of course. Never heard of it. Well, neither have I. But today, we're going to get a chance to live the day in the life of the SCA. We're here with Brandon Butler. So tell us a little about yourself, Brandon.
Well, my name is Brendan Butler. I'm a freshman philosophy major here at the University of Houston, but in the society, I'm known as Lord Brian O'Culio. I am a 12th century Irishman who is the son of a nobleman who was educated in the church, so my persona has a church background as well as a fighting background.
Nice, okay. Tell us, you see this, tell us a little about what you guys do and what y'all do here.
Well, we create Renaissance and medieval fighting.
Okay.
Particularly tournament warfare. We have our what we call chivalric fighters here recreating a tournament, or actually a practice field. Historically speaking, in medieval times, they would actually use wooden swords to practice and teach young fighters.
Really?
So we're recreating this. We're not, of course, using live steel because we don't truly want to injure people. And on this closer field, we have what we call rapier fighting. It's similar to swashbuckling or stuff you might see in Three Musketeers. And so tell me, would you like to learn something hands-on?
Absolutely.
Fantastic.
Is it all looking good?
Yeah.
Does it say anything if you get your head cut off?
Yeah.
You see this? You see what the Channel 6 puts me through?
I need a pay raise. I need pay and gym.
A fencing jacket must be rated to 550 newtons. This is actually above that, but this is basically, if the blade happens to break, this would stop it. So if you just put that on. Just like a regular.
Oh yeah, this is.
Yo, do you mind if I borrow that thing?
Pretty cool.
Yeah, right?
This is a simple setup we use. You can see this is what's called the bell guard. This is modified to just look better, but this essentially protects your hand. So if somebody was to throw a shot, it wouldn't get through. These bars coming off are called quillions, and if someone were to throw a shot, I could throw them off using the quillions and bind them up.
Sure.
So if you grab that, and you can just put your finger right through there,
right there.
And that gives you a little better grip. And see, what it does is if you get in your stance like this, if you were to put your arm up a little more, bend it down here, pull it back more. All right, that's a pretty decent stance.
Oh yeah.
And what this does is, I can't get your hand now.
Oh yeah.
And if I were to throw a shot here, if you just turned, you just threw my blade off with your quillion.
Oh right.
Same thing happens with the knuckle bow. You can throw that off, and that gives a little hand protection. In collegiate or Olympic fencing, is maybe they'll have their hand back here or just rested. In our group, you can actually have your hand up, because if you were to try to hit me in the chest slowly, I can do that. That's a simple hand parry. All I did was I knocked your blade out of the way with my hand. Similarly, I can do that with my sword. Throw the same shot, and you'll notice my point is still online, while yours is not. So this protects myself and gives me a great advantage to come in and kill you.
On the offense. Good defense setting up the offense, right?
Exactly.
Yes, sir.
Protect yourself with your hand. Knock it out of the way. Yeah. So you try to take a shot on me again.
Flat, but it felt good. I can
throw that.
Good.
Now I'm going to show you a couple of fancier moves. So if you get on guard, try to block this with your sword. If I throw this shot,
that was
a simple disengage.
It's
called a disengage.
Okay.
So if I try to do that, I'm dead now. So I've got to be able to
counter-carry
and disengage. I've got to be able to come back.
Right.
But I don't know if you're going to do that.
Yeah, sure.
Likewise.
You can fake it, and then you can go for it.
Exactly. Yeah. Likewise, I can fake the disengage and then come back.
Oh, yeah.
So you've got to be on the watch. You've got to think. It's really a physical game of chess.
Physical game of chess.
That's a good one. Dude, John, go like, yes, yes. Just go, yes, yes.
I don't know, man. They got sticks and stuff, dude. I totally don't want to. I don't want to choose sides. You know? Holy steady. That's good. Remember, you're going to do it a few times. You're going to get closer shots. Oh. Here, try to get closer now. Don't get too close, dude. You're going to be running around.
No, this guy, I'm going. UT rocks, U of H and Mr. Bot suck!
Cougars! Cougars! Cougars!